published 1950 EDT, the 28th of August 2017, updated 1950 EDT, the 28th of August 2017. Mark McGhee has watched Oliver Burke scale heights where the football other Scottish players can't reach. "We played England at Wembley and trained at Barnet before the game," recalled Gordon Strachan's right-hand man yesterday. "We were walking off the training pitch towards the changing rooms at one corner of the pitch. Oliver was in front of me and a ball rolled over and he was maybe 5 yards from the touchline and 5 yards from the byline and did one of these rabonas with his left foot, and bear in mind he's right-footed." Mark McGhee is backing Oliver Burke to rediscover his best form with West Brom. "I couldn't do it with my right foot well, the ball flew to the back post and I'd never seen anything like it. It was outstanding, the power and the accuracy, and that's what he has. I've also never seen anyone quicker in all my years in the game. He now has to apply that to his game. This, for Burke, is the challenge." At 20, the Kirkcaldy-born winger has racked up transfer fees worth £27 million. He is the most expensive Scottish footballer of all time. But the solid end product has yet to match the hype and the hullabaloo of last year. Burke joined Tony Puller's team for £15 million from Bundesliga side Red Bull Leipzig last week. A former Hamburg player himself, McGhee describes Burke's swift return to England 12 months after joining RB Leipzig as disappointing. "But after just 5 starts out of 25 appearances, Burke needs a portfolio of games, a solid run of appearances with West Brom to justify a return to the senior national team after Gordon Strachan took him out of the front line. It's really disappointing," said McGhee of Burke's move back from Germany. "But he's moved to a fantastic league and an established club." The 20-year-old came off the substitutes bench to make his debut on Saturday, has got a great move back, but he hasn't performed the way they would have hoped, and I don't know what has happened that persuaded Leipzig to let him come back. "We think he's a tremendous talent, but he needs to play games and find a way of playing and find his game. At the moment, his strengths, power, size, crossing ability and goal-scoring potential is huge, but he has to find his place in a team, and he can only do that by playing games. At 6 feet 2 inches, with pace, power and physicality, Burke has attributes Scotland's national team needs, and that might explain a natural rush to pitch him into the senior team at the age of 19 against Malta. By the time the Scots faced Slovenia in September, he couldn't make the bench but started against Lithuania days later. An unused substitute in the 30-2 England at Wembley, he was substituted at halftime of a wretched friendly against Canada in March, taking him out of the firing line after discussions with performance director Malky Mackay. Strachan accepted some degree of culpability when he admitted promoting Burke before he was fully established at club level. "I think we need to be patient with him and not write him off this year," said McGhee. "He has to learn to be part of a team." McGhee said it was disappointing the winger didn't make a success of his move to Germany. The pacey winger failed to establish a first-team spot in the one season he spent at Leipzig. He's still raw even though he's been in Germany. "I hope the German way has rubbed off on him." When Scotland drew 22 with England in June, Burke was captaining the under-20 team in Toulon and is expected to make his under-21 debut against Holland next week. When he went away with the under-20s in the summer, the report back on him was outstanding, added McGhee. "He was made of captain and he played and behaved like a captain. Clearly, he has the potential to be that disciplined player as shown with the younger team. If he can do that, he'll be fine. But McGhee believes he is a tremendous talent and just needs more game time to improve. I don't know if the language in Germany has been difficult for him, because it's not an easy thing to go abroad. I've been to Germany and it's not easy when you don't speak the language. Maybe he has found that difficult." McGhee remains unconvinced Burke's long-term future is on the flank. "Versatility can be a curse for a professional footballer, but," McGhee insisted, "I can't speak for Tony Pulis, West Brom boss, but we all feel that one of Oliver's potential positions is through the middle. You know, with the pace he's got, it may be that, away from home, if they can get the ball in behind for him running after it, nobody will catch him.